Hi, and thanks for logging on to the Daily Devar Halacha. Here's a brand new halacha for you, and it's for Tuesday, the 23rd day of December. Here we go. A reminder again that you're in the middle of a 2-day Rosh Chodesh. It started on Sunday night, and it ends with the end of the daytime time on Tuesday. This would be the perfect time for me to explain an important thing about what exactly it is when we say half hallel and whole hallel, especially because these are the most two confusing days of the year on it. Usually on Rosh Chodesh we say what we call the half hallel, and usually on Hanukkah we say the whole hallel, and here we are in the middle of Rosh Chodesh and Hanukkah at the same time. And as I told you, the overriding factor is Hanukkah, and therefore we do say the full hallel. But let's step back and explain what's going on here with the half and the whole. You see, the way it really works is that we say the entire hallel whenever there is a full-fledged mitzvah to do that hallel. Like, for example, in all the days of Sukkos, each and every day of Sukkos is like its own it has its own specific identity, its own special sacrifice, and therefore each and every day of Sukkos is considered like a festival, kind of on its own, kind of, even the Chol HaMoed, and therefore we have a full command to rejoice and say Hallel throughout all of the days of Sukkos. On Pesach, however, there's really just one set karban, one sacrifice that's brought throughout, and therefore all of the days of Pesach are not viewed as distinctly separate holidays the way we view Sukkos. Also, I should mention to you that when Sukkos has its Chol HaMoed end and Shmini Atzeres gets added on at the end, the Shmini Atzeres, that's the last Yom Tov of Sukkos, is its own separate identity, and it's not like a continuation of Sukkos. Pesach, on the other hand, when we have the last day of Yom Tov of Pesach, it's a smooth continuation of the Pesach that was, and therefore it's harder for those last 6 days of Pesach to get their own separate identity broken away from that first special solid day of Yom Tov. It's viewed more like the rest of Pesach is the continuation of that same sacrifice each day. Therefore, on the last days of Pesach, meaning all of Chol HaMoed and the Yom Tov, that's at the end of Pesach, there is no mitzvah to say Hallel. So, and on Rosh Chodesh also, there's no mitzvah to say Hallel. We have a custom to say Hallel in order to distinguish and show that the Hallel that we're saying is different and separate and apart from the real Hallel that's commanded, like on all the days of Sukkos. So we just take away two of the paragraphs. We call it half Hallel. It's not exactly half, but that's what we call it. And that's our way of signifying this is not the same kind of command Hallel that you do on all the days of Sukkos and Shmini Atzeres. It's a customary Hallel that we choose to say on the last day. Not that it's an option anymore. We all do it, but it's come through custom, and therefore we signify that by saying two less of the paragraphs of Hallel, and so we call it half Hallel. And that's what we do on a regular Rosh Chodesh. But on Hanukkah, where there is a command to say Hallel, we say the full Hallel, and that is why we are doing it that way. Hope that makes it more clear. Thanks for logging on. You now understand a little bit more about what half Hallel really is. Log on again tomorrow for more. Bye-bye.